Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm talking about how I save money on a teaching abroad income. In case you didn't realize this, teaching abroad or teaching English abroad as a foreign language is not the highest paid profession. I've heard people saying that teachers in the US don't even get paid enough, so if you decide to teach somewhere else, usually you're dropping your income even lower than that. But obviously, as I've mentioned before, this career is not so much about the pay and it's more about the experience of living and experiencing a different culture. That being said, obviously we still need money to live and survive in this world, so if you are looking into moving abroad or teaching abroad and you are a bit concerned about the money, let me give you one trick that I believe is the most important thing to be able to save money while living abroad. Let me give you a look into how I save roughly half my income teaching abroad. To start off, I have to say that there are several aspects of the way that I personally live my life that tend to make my life less expensive. For example, I don't drink any alcohol, I don't really eat out that much, and I don't really go out and do a lot of things either. So those three things combined do save me a decent amount of money. Another huge aspect of how I'm able to save money is that in Honduras and also here in the Dominican Republic, my rent has been covered by the school. So that is obviously a huge living expense for many people wherever you are. So that is a great blessing, and I'm very grateful that I do not have to spend money on that. Now, even if those lifestyle aspects do not apply to you, let me give you the biggest tip that will help you save money wherever you're living. The biggest advice I can give you is to just try to live like a native of the country where you're moving to. This mostly has to do with food, but it does cover a few other aspects of life that I will explain in just a moment. But overall, you should just consider living by this lifestyle with regards to your overall living standards. Now, maybe this is just my perspective as someone who has lived in the US and I've been living in countries that mostly have a lower standard of living than the US. But let me just say, if you're trying to live like an American in virtually any place but America, not only are you not likely to get all your expectations met, but it will cost you a lot more. The best example of this is with food. In Honduras, there are many American brand items that were imported to Honduras, but if I was trying to eat American foods every chance I got, I would be paying extra for those items, plus the extra tax on imported items. Here in the DR, there are even more options for American food than where I was in Honduras, which I think is primarily due to the fact I was living in a more rural, small town area in Honduras, and here I'm living in a bigger city. Obviously, as you get more into rural, smaller regions, you're not going to find as many imported big name American brands, but living here in the capital in Santo Domingo, you do see a lot of options for American food. So if you really want to save money, you should try to live like a native, or in this case, live like a Dominican, eat like a Dominican, and try to really dive into their culture and their food. I've heard a lot of people saying groceries can get expensive here, which is true, but if you try to avoid buying imported items and buy more products that Dominicans would buy, this will help you save money in the long run. And there are a few reasons this will help you save money. Number one, the items that you're buying are going to be the ones that are easy to find because everyone is buying them. You won't have to go to a specialty store, you won't have to travel a long way to find that grocery store that has that one item you need. You can find these items just about anywhere, even at the local colmado. Number two is that you'll be buying mostly local produce, so you won't be buying as much of the imported stuff that is going to be priced higher and taxed. And that goes along with number three, you won't be buying imported items. However, obviously, sometimes we do get attached to those brand names, whether it's a toiletry item or a brand name food item. And as far as toiletries go, I do bring most of my toiletries with me when I come here, so that also helps me save a bit while I'm actually here, even though it's a bigger cost while I'm in the States, because then I don't have to buy them as frequently while I'm living here. Plus, I don't have to worry about finding the right shampoo or conditioner here versus the States, where I know there's a certain store where I could go to find that brand. So in that aspect, yes, I am living very much like an American. Another area where you can follow this principle of living like a native is transportation. Public transportation is a very viable option and is very popular for a reason. It's the cheapest way to get around, especially if you're just looking to get from one sector of the city to another. As a tourist, the easiest way to go to a place might just be to get an Uber. For example, if you need to go to the beach, it might be a little bit more expensive to take an Uber, but if you don't feel like trying to figure out the public transportation system and catching a bus and then having to walk a little bit, then yes, it might be more convenient to just do Uber. But if you really want to learn how people live here, you can take public transportation to just about any area, to the beach, to Zona Colonial, to the center of the city, wherever you want to go, you can find public transportation, and that will help cut your costs a lot. Definitely, if you live here more long-term, it is worth it to try to figure out the public transportation system, at least to places that you go frequently and are fairly far apart. Although I will admit, Uber is comfortable, it's convenient, most of the time. I've had some issues with Uber, but maybe I'll do that in another video. Another way to live more like a Dominican and less like an American is to avoid tourist traps. What I mean by that is that if you're looking to do some sightseeing or touring around the country, avoid tours or other packages that are neatly packaged. They make it very convenient for you and they are marketed towards tourists. And instead, look at what the Dominicans are doing or try to figure out a way of giving yourself the tour. For example, when I was in Barahona, there were advertisements for tours to the cave, La Cueva de la Virgen, that my roommate and I wanted to go to. And they were priced pretty high, around 4,000 pesos. So my roommate and I, being frugal people, decided to just try to do it ourselves. That didn't exactly go very well for us. We did end up running into a local though, and he showed us the way to the cave. He stayed with us all day. He was very kind and we are very grateful for him. And we did end up giving him a little thank you for his time at the end of the day. But overall, it was still a lot cheaper than it would have been to try to get one of the official tour guides. Overall, the biggest way to save money while living abroad is to be flexible and adapt your lifestyle to the country you're living in. Try new things, maybe adjust your diet a little bit. Don't buy so many imported American items and don't fall into tourist traps. If you implement these tips, I am certain that you will be spending less money than you would be trying to imitate an American lifestyle while living abroad. That brings us to the conclusion of today's video. Thank you so much for watching. If you want more videos like this, please let me know in the comments. And with that, I hope you have a great rest of your day. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Also, please ignore the fact that I am sweating bullets because it is very hot here. Very hot.